Thank you. the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered, conquered the grave. Conquered death. Conquered death. He defeated death. He's the victor today. You are the victor today. For you conquered the grave. All those dead spots in our life. You are worthy. You are worthy. Conquer the grave. Conquer the grave.
Forever changed.
chain. Never the same.
Thank you. heritage. It's He's more than enough for redemption. And that's what we're doing here this weekend. Man, we are discovering redemption. And this morning, I had a funny memory came to my mind, and I'm going to now share it with you. And it's a children's church memory. How many of you have been to a happening children's church in your life? Yeah? So Naomi, who's painting over here, her brother Ross used to be our children's pastor, and he used to do this skit in children's church, and Sam Brownback, who's going to do the offering today, was his assistant. And what he did is he had a patient on a table, and I think his name was Dr. Oinks. I'm not sure the etymology of that namage. However, he was Dr. Oinks, and first he did a heart transplant. Were you the patient or the assistant? The patient. Yeah, I think Sam was the patient. I wish I had a photo. He was 12 at the time. First he had a heart transplant, but guess what? He didn't stop there. Dr. Oinks is a type of the Holy Spirit, though his surgeries are better, the Holy Spirit's are. He did a heart transplant, and then he did an eye transplant. Because if you don't have an eye transplant, you can't see what happened in your heart. And Joey went off laughing a minute ago, and I really thought, you know what? He's just seeing some things. He's having some things go off. He's having some eye transplant, some irradiation. Ephesians 1 talks about the eyes of your heart being flooded with light. How many of you think that might come out of your mouth when that happens? And then Dr. Oinks didn't stop there. No, so wise was Dr. Oinks that the third transplant was a brain transplant. But can I tell you, if you try the brain transplant without the eye transplant, you've missed something. You've got a clone. So mind renewal, like Romans 12, 1 and 2 talks about, is about having your eyes irradiated with a dose of light. And that is what we have been doing. If you are a candidate for more of that, can we just pray into that one more time this morning? We don't know everything, do we? Man, there's people in this room, Dr. Howell's probably chief among them, that have studied their whole life to meditate into the truth of redemption. And yet he would be the first to admit, I want more. There's more to see. There's more to be changed. The point is being a transformed man. The heart transplant, born again, hallelujah. But so many of the church stopped there and did not have the subsequent transplants. Hey, Children's Church has got all the wisdom. We just need to pray into that. So how many of you today want more eye transplant? Father, we just come to you as your people and we declare we are so grateful for redemption. We are so grateful you are worthy to take the book and open the seals thereof. You were worthy to unlock the locked up places in our heart. You are worthy. You're more than enough. You have the right and ownership and ability and power to unlock every bit of us. You're worthy. But Lord, we say now, keep working on that eye transplant. And Lord, we know our behavior and our brains are only going to be changed as our eyes see. So, Father, today we receive encounters. We receive heaven's encounters on the screen of our inner man. We say yes to that. Somebody right now is saying a yes to it, and it's going to happen. Somebody right now that is saying yes to that, you're going to have a photographic image on your heart today that you're going to carry with you the rest of your life. I believe that from the teaching and preaching that goes forth this morning. We're not just praying to take up space. We're praying because we posture our hearts to receive the way God wants to give, not our own ideas of how church ought to be. Father, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you for the laughter that buzzes off when we see you. And we are released from our own efforts that have worn us out. That's why there's strength in the building. That's why there's rest in the building, because we're discovering as God's people that our own efforts are no longer necessary. Can you just, it's a strange thing to ask you to do, but if that resonates with you, just breathe a sigh. Isn't that great? Isn't that fantastic? Amen. You guys can be seated. We're going to move on, but we're not moving on. Thank you, worship team. You guys were leading us there. Wonderful. Yeah, give them a hand. We are unapologetic fans of the Abbey worship team. We love them. We will remind you, next Sunday is Father's Day, so we will have a gift for dads, and bring your dad to church. It would be a great thing, and we love being together on family days. And then the Saturday following on 6/23, June 23rd, at 9:30 a.m., we have the Abbey Wonder Woman, which we just called them that because this year's theme is the X Factor. And what did Wonder Woman do in the movie? Right? Thank you. She made an X. Okay, that didn't go over as big as I thought. But nevertheless, that is the case. And we are going to be watching the film The Greatest Showman together. And at the end, we're going to be shouting a little bit about our freedom in Christ. So come on out. If you haven't seen it or if you have, I don't even want to tell you how many times I've seen it. So I'm not going to. And I did say earlier, you know, that you could sing along, but I'm not sure if we should promise that. Anyway, the messages from this weekend. We are going to be providing a jump drive very soon. If you just want to own them in your own digital hands, we will have a jump drive filled with those for purchase. But if you need them more immediately, they are things you're going to want. If you were here, you still want them to go back and hear again and again. And so they're already ready on YouTube. Toby, is Toby back there? I cannot see. Listen, Toby's right up there, and he's filmed all these, and he's already got them loaded, the worship and the message. And when, if you haven't used our YouTube channel before, you type in the Abbey Church, you click on the Abbey logo, which you'll see there. It's the same as the app. And when you first go to that screen, it says no content. That just means we haven't written a paragraph telling you who we are. I'm going to remedy that. But don't believe no content. Just click on videos. And when you click on videos, all of the videos will show up. And this group of teachings are under Grace Upon Grace, a heading, Grace Upon Grace. And Toby's just said, if you will please click on subscribe and then click the little bell for notifications, it builds our channel and also it'll notify you when a new video is posted. So that is a great immediate way, and we really appreciate all Toby's done on that. And at this point, we have a one of our own, one of our youth leaders, who also is our son, coming to receive our offering this morning. This is Sam Brownback.
Thank you. Thank you. Isn't God good? Yeah. How, show of hands, who's been here this weekend? Man, isn't grace bigger than, I mean, I could even imagine. So whenever Mom told me I was going to be doing offering 2 weeks ago, I just finished a class in hermeneutics, so I was like, man, this is going to be great. I'm going to give, like, historical context on the tithe, literary context. I'm going to go deep, because Dr. Lynn Hiles is deep, so I'm going to go super deep and prepare them for the what's to come. So I sat out there preparing my message for youth and was digging into the tithe, and so I Googled, is tithe biblical? And maybe you shouldn't Google that, because there are some titles that are like, and so I think most of the titles are clickbait, like it's just to kind of get you a rise. Like there's titles that are like, we are, Christians should never tithe, Christians are above the tithe, like it's pre-law, all this stuff. So I was like, well, what do I believe about it? And God really placed something on my heart, and man, I hope I can get it out accurately in my head because I'm super passionate about it. The tithe was never, it was never given, it's not a set of rules. It's not something, God dropped the relationship that I have with Kylie. And if you think about it, like whenever I was dating her, money was no question. I would take her out to eat. I forgot how much money I had in my bank account. Like, I'd buy her phone cases, like just, eventually, Dad had to be like, hey, you need a budget. You're, like, spending more money than you should. But why is that relationship any different than this relationship? Why is the tithe? I never sat down with Kylie and said, hey, I want to date you, so I'm going to give you 10% of every thing I own. That's a set of rules. That's not a relationship. That's not a covenant. So true covenant is, like, grace says I don't have to give God 10%. But faith says, I get to give God 10%. It's all his anyways. God doesn't want just my money. He wants all of me. And if I can represent giving all of me by giving God 10%, that's an amazing opportunity that I get to have in church. And, you know, as Papa, Daddy, God, like, as a son, Lynn said it this week, the more I worship God, he's not going to, like, he wants to give back to us. You can't outgive God. Like, he's going to honor that relationship. So I saw that super strongly, and it burdens me that the church says, in general, says that the tithe is required, and it's under law, it's pre-law, all this stuff. Like, that's an opportunity to sow into ministry and advance the kingdom. So I hope that came across really well. Thank you. So go ahead and put up the tithe and offering, the ways, different ways to give, if you can, media team. I'm going to pray over y'all just for the offering that's a blessing. God, we just thank you for the relationship we have with you, and that you're Papa, Daddy, God. We just thank you that everything that is given to us is, we're blessed to be a blessing, God. And we just thank you that we call in new jobs, promotions, witty inventions, just all the blessings you have in store for us, that these tithes and offerings, dollars, won't go to waste, that you're going to use them to advance the kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.